Hello. In this video, you will learn a version of the chain rule for functions of two variables. Let's recall the chain rule for a composite function of one variable. For example, if you want to compute the derivative of the sine of the square root of x, it is the derivative of the sine evaluated at the square root of x times the derivative of the square root of x, which is equal to the cosine of the square root of x times 1 over 2 times the square root of x. The general formula for the chain rule for functions of one variable is here. The derivative of a composite function is the derivative of the outer function evaluated at the inner function times the derivative of the inner function. But you are working with functions of several variables. So in this video, you will learn a version of the chain rule that you can apply to compute the derivative of a composite function of several variables. To find this chain rule, let's look at a function of two variables and suppose these variables themselves are both functions depending on some new variable. Let's say f is the function depending on two variables x and y, and x and y both depend on a variable t. This occurs, for example, in the following situation. Suppose you are hiking in the mountains and you want to know the slope of the route you are taking. Then you would need to know how fast your height changes. So first, you need to know where you are on the mountain at each time. This means your location in terms of your x and y coordinates at time t. Secondly, you need to know what the height of the mountain is at each location. Thus, there are three functions at play. Xt and yt give your location, and h, depending on x and y, gives the height of the mountain at that location. You want to find out how quickly h changes with t while walking along the path. So you are looking for the derivative of h with respect to t after plugging in the functions xt and yt. You see, you are now in desperate need of a more extensive version of the chain rule. Let's look at a simple situation. The function f is the formula for the plane given by the equation z equals 2 times x plus 3 times y minus 1, where x is 1/3 times t plus 2 and y is 1/4 times t minus 3. Then you can calculate the derivative of f with respect to t directly by plugging in the expressions for x and y into the formula of f. This gives you f is equal to 2 times 1/3 times t plus 2 plus 3 times 1/4 times t minus 3 minus 1. So the derivative of f equals 2 times 1/3 plus 3 times 1/4. This derivative has two components. One term associated to the change in x and one term associated to the change in y. The picture shows what this means. If t increases by 1, we change both the x and the y coordinates slightly. Instead of going directly to the new point following the red line, we can first take a step in the x direction of length 1/3, followed by a step in the y direction of length 1/4, following the blue lines. The total change in height is the sum of the changes for each of these two small steps. The change in height for the x step equals the size of the step times the slope in this direction, illustrated by the height of the blue triangle at the front of the picture. That is, it equals the derivative of f with respect to x times the derivative of x with respect to t. Likewise, the change in height for the step in the y direction equals the length of the y step times the slope in the y direction, which is the product of the derivative of f with respect to y times the derivative of y with respect to t. This is the chain rule. The chain rule gives you a method of calculating a derivative in the case there is a chain of functions plugged into each other. Here it is. Let z be equal to f depending on xt and yt, then the derivative of z with respect to t is equal to the partial derivative of f with respect to x times the derivative of x with respect to t plus the partial derivative of f with respect to y times the derivative of y with respect to t. Let's see how this works in the example we discussed before. You had the functions f of x and y, x of t and y of t, and you computed the derivative of z with respect to t directly by plugging in the expressions for x and y. Now, if you apply the chain rule, you get that the partial derivative of f with respect to x is equal to 2, and the derivative of x with respect to t equals 1/3. The partial derivative of f with respect to y is equal to 3, and finally, the derivative of y with respect to t is 1/4, which is exactly what you found before. This is the simplest case of the chain rule for functions of several variables. You will encounter more complicated cases in class. Here is a question you can think about before coming to class. Look at the function x squared times y plus 3x times y to the fourth, with x equal to the sine of 2 times t and y equal to the cosine of 2 times t. Now, compute the rate of change of z at time t equals pi using the chain rule. Thank you for watching.